Yow! What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to another little Yow vlog. We're going to be going over the tough break update, the latest patch from the Valve Software Team Fortress team. Yeah, these guys kick ass. Let's run it down. So, great little graphics here. Miss Pauling. We're going to be jamming through this. You guys can read into it a little bit more. $5.99 is the price for the campaign pass. I've already picked mine up. And, so far the first couple missions are pretty fun and a little bit different than before. We'll see. I'm not too thrilled to be, like, getting crates as rewards that I then have to pay more money to open. But, you know, of course, I don't really spend too much money on TF2, and I'm totally fine with this sort of structure. Obviously, when we also get awesome, awesome balance updates that nobody has to pay for. So, running into this, you know, this just talks about the contracts. There's the loaner program that just kind of is the kind of easier way. I mean, all that stuff was available before. Four new collections. There's plenty of swaggin' items in here. I like those guys, the Macabre Web Scatterguns. There's the whole set of Macabre, not just the Web Scattergun. But yeah, a lot of cool stuff there. More items, more skins, more stuff to find, to sell. More maps, so awesome stuff here. We got Snowy Coast. I played this just a little bit earlier today, and I was enjoying it thoroughly. People didn't really know how to defend. I think we almost got to the end of the first map. I don't even know if there is multiple stages, but it was very cool. I was enjoying that. Vanguard is the map that they did have in UGC League at the end of the last season, and it's an all right map. It's definitely getting geared more towards Highlander. Which is cool. That's where FUBAR is kind of focusing the efforts on. And I was enjoying it, but I think it just needs a little bit more play, too. You know how it goes. High Pass, I don't believe that I have played this one on King of the Hill yet or ever. Same thing with Landfall, because it's a Capture the Flag map. So that's, again, very cool that we're just getting more maps, more stuff coming in. Then also new taunts. Yep, cool stuff there. But here, this is really the meat of the update, the Tough Break gameplay changes, and definitely some very cool stuff in here. First off, right out of the gates, I love this, base weapon switch speed changed from 0.67 seconds to 0.5 seconds. So that's cool, a little bit helpful, more helpful for everybody. I think this is also great. Upon spawning, friendly players will show an outline for 10 seconds. Just kind of gives you like a heads up of which direction to go, where people are, if there's that many people up in front of you, whatever. And then I don't know everything that was updated there, but definitely cool stuff there. So let's go through this panic attack. I'll just try to skim through this because I definitely read this earlier. The reserve shooter adjusted, so no longer mini crits any airborne target. So people that are just jumping, that is a fantastic change. Also, they've made several changes to different weapons, basically changing, splitting up like switching to a weapon and switching from a weapon, as you can see with this one. So that's pretty interesting. Changes to the half Zato Ichi. No longer, cannot be holstered if players below 50 life and no kill was made. So there you go. It does deal 50 self damage on holster if no kill was made. Yeah, interesting stuff there. 50% health gain on kill that can result in overheal. That's pretty cool that result in overheal. Some changes down here. Pretty Boy's pocket pistol, health recovered on hit, 3-5. That's a pretty big change. That might make the Pretty Boy pocket pistol a little bit more useful. The Mad Milk, basically every liquid and some of the other effects similar to this were given this bonus. So extinguishing an ally, it reduces the cooldown by 20%. That's a very cool, very good change. Rap Assassin change so that the ornament shatters on impacts. Deals damage in a small radius, recharge rate increased, damage penalty reduced, sure. Baker's Bazooka splash damage radius reduced, so that's really good. Conquer, this is a surprising one, and a very strong one for Soldier. Doubled health regeneration rate. Regeneration rate decreased if you've been recently damaged. So I already favored this as a roamer, or just like Highlander, you know, kind of style. Be able to stay away from your medic and get those heals. And so I think that's super powerful for Highlander, and is a big boost. Remove hidden property of updraft when on fire. Market Gardener, swing slower. Reduce blast radius by 20% when rocket jumping on airstrike. So that's interesting. Over here, this is a huge one. Cozy Camber quadrupled health regeneration rate. I'm not sure if that's crazy or not. Also, a crikey meter added for sniper, which is filled when dealing damage and then activates when you have a full crikey meter. So that's pretty interesting. Definitely has a possible submachine gun option. Maybe just for pubs, but we'll see in Highlander. And then this is cool, yeah. Pyro's extinguishing teammate returns 20 health to the Pyro. Love that. And then consecutive air blasts will no longer prevent enemies from air strafing until they touch the ground. Definitely, I'm sure somebody will be making a demonstration video of this exact effect and how it has changed now. I need to play with it a little bit more, but that's a very positive change for how people feel playing against the Pyro. I think this was something that was brought up at the meeting that we went to at Valve in April, but definitely something that was mentioned by Banny recently in a video. Also mentioned by Vanny recently, it was like a stream highlight more so, was possibly changing the degreaser to have a downside to it, mainly particularly to the air blast. So there you have air blast cost reduced, increased by 25%. So that's a very positive change. I think that just, you know, forces a little bit more versatility in the pyro guns. The removed phlogistonator 10% damage penalty, so that might make it a little bit more viable as a competitive option. Some people might not like hearing me say that, but that is the truth. Extinguisher, love this. Properties changed. Critting against burning targets, damage penalty, slower attack speed, slower switch to speed. So very positive stuff there, I feel. Awesome changes for the medic. Slightly higher regeneration when healing a hurt patient. Keyword there is hurt, so if you're buffing people, you will not get that regen, or bonus regen, rather. During setup time, build rate is increased by 3 times. That's a super positive change if you happen to change guns in the middle of building. In the beginning of the game, you know, you'll be all right. No problem there. Excuse me, this is turning into a lengthier video. Anyways, Vaccinator, some changes to that are pretty interesting. I guess that's good, removing the regeneration on proper resist. Slight ubercharge build on proper resist included the rate. Reduced the ubercharge build rate penalty on the overhealed. That's an interesting one. Awesome change to the Crusader's crossbow. Healing a player with an arrow now grants a small amount of ubercharge. So now when you whip out your arrows to heal somebody, you're not, if your arrow connects, you're not losing out on ubercharge percentage. So that's awesome. And then I love this change as well. Players can no longer capture objectives while under the effects of quick fix ubercharge. This is something that we ran into in Arena Respawn for sure as being a problem. But also something that I kind of suggested, and I think has definitely hampered the balancing of the quick fix. Changes to the spy, further nearest to the dead ringer, which I approve of. And changes to the heavy, where most of these have, it's just different penalties here. So fist of seal, bringing it out, it seems like there's not a time penalty, but holstering it, there's a time penalty, which is interesting, but that does play into the bonus melee damage you take. Increasing the holster time penalty on the GRU means that the mark for death will be on you longer. The Warrior's Spirit is interesting positive changes there, with 50 health on kill added to it and damage received and dealt increased, and then removing the health penalty. And then the Eviction Notice, the interesting changes there as well. So here we are with the Demo Man, Demo Knight. Big change to Shield Bash. Melee damage boost after Shield Bash is based on amount of charge consumed, which is the distance you've charged. So it provides mini crit at 25% depleted and full crit at 60%. And then charging removes debuffs from Demo Knight, which is pretty cool and a nice effect. All swords have a slower deploy and holster speed. Good change. And then changes to all the shields just a little bit. So Splendid Screen regens faster. Tide Turner grants mini crit instead of full crit on charge bash, which I think still makes it a super strong choice here. Charge and Targe just reduce the resistance a little bit and remove the fire immunity, which I think is a positive change there. Cladmore restores 25 health on kill, which is interesting. Remove the charge bonus. So you don't get the extra length. Clade and charge and charge is really strong. Persian Persuader removed ammo pickups granting health instead of ammo, which is awesome because that was kind of bogus when you really were going for it. And then added penalties of reduced primary and secondary ammo. So I think that's a good exchange. And then ammo pickups that replenish charge, which is pretty crazy. I haven't played with that in a while, so I'm not sure how you get ammo at all, if you need a dispenser or if the packs from people give you ammo or if you're just screwed. Quickie Bomb launch will fizzle time increase from 2 seconds to 4 seconds, so kind of surprising to see that one get a buff, but maybe it just needs to get played a little bit more still. Ulapool Caber also kind of buffed a little bit, but a little bit of penalty time there. Loose Cannon nerfed with reduced projectile speed and reduced cannon impact damage. Damage scaling with distance. I don't know if that's an upscale or a downscale, but that's a little worrying. Maybe somebody in the comments can sound off on that. And then reduced knockback from cannon hit. So knockback strength is similar to Air Blast. That's real positive. Nothing too crazy out of those knockbacks. Wow, that's a huge change. I actually didn't read that before. So after removing a sapper from a sentry, there's now a half a second delay before the sentry is active again. That's definitely a big boost for teamwork. And that's very cool as well. Sentries brought into a respawn room no longer detonate. That's a big deal for steel. The Jag added damage penalty against buildings. So 3 hits to destroy a sapper. That's good balance. And then Rescue Ranger nerfed down a little bit, and that's a good balance as well. I'm not really going to go over anything in here. I guess I will say this. The ping was replaced with an image to represent ping values, but you can change that back to default. So there you go. And I think that was about it down here. Some adjustments to Mac and Linux and some changes to manpower as well. But I haven't really played that a whole lot, so I'm not really going to comment on those. I'll let you read it yourself on the side there. There you are, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm going to do a rundown of this for Dota as well, because there was also some awesome Dota changes that came down the line, and I want to run those down for you guys. I think I'm going to do them from the perspective of Elder Titan, because that's what I play, and should be fun to go over the patch like that with that perspective. So thanks for tuning in, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Eckstein. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out!